In this video, we will talk about a very tricky WCF interview question. Does WCF support method overloading? Now, many people who have been working with WCF service, you know, will think that yes, it will, it should support, I mean to say, method overloading. Why? Because WCF's main programming language is C#, and C# is object oriented. So definitely WCF should also support method overloading. But actually the answer is no. Okay. So let me explain you why. Okay. So you can see that I have gone ahead and I've created a very simple WCF service here called as WCF service method overloading. And when I did that, you can see that the default code, you know, which the WCF generate is seen on the screen. So let me go ahead here and create. Now you can see that there is a simple function here saying public string get data. So I'll go and create. First I have to go to the service here. So let me go to the service here and let me go and create one more function which is overloaded. So I'll create one more get data function, and I'm going to go and overload this get data function. So you can see that I have created one more function get data with two inputs, value as well as value one. So now in this WCF service we have the get data function which is overloaded. Okay, so one get data function takes only one input, while the other get data function takes two input. Now let's see how this works. So let's go to our service1.svc.cs and let me go and implement this get data function. So I'm going to say and implement the service. So you can see that it has gone ahead and put some code here. I will currently not write any kind of code. Let me just control S this. Let me go and build this. And good. Okay. And let me try to go and run this WCF service. So I'll do a control F5 here and let's see what happens. So there it is going and running my WCF test client. Now the WCF test client is nothing but it's a test client which is provided by the WCF team, you know, to go and test your service. Right, so it is giving me certain errors here, and you know, what I'll do is, let me go and copy this error into the notepad. Okay. And let's try to read this error, what it says. So I'm going to say here notepad and say control V. Okay. Long error. So very difficult to see that in the dialog box. So I have copy pasted that in the notepad here. Okay. Now you can see over here, what he's saying is, let me go and show you the error. Here it is. So you can see that what he's saying is, this is the most important statement here. Okay. And the other things we can just leave it. It says that the request failed. Why? Because, you know, you cannot have two operations in the same contract with the same name. So methods get data and get data in type, it's actually method overloading and it's violating this rule. So can you do one thing? Can you go and change the name of the operation by changing the method name or by using the name property of operation contract? So in other words, you know, he's complaining that, you know, you cannot do method overloading in WCF service. And if you want to do that, please go ahead and use the operation contract attribute and use the name property. Okay. So as he has suggested to use the name property of operation contract attribute, let's again go back to a WCF service. And let's make the correction and let's see if it now accepts it or not. So I'm going to go here and say that, okay, this get data, I will call it as, let's say get data. Okay. And this get data, I'll call it as get data one. Great. Now let's build this. And let's again try to run this solution. Let's do a control F5. So there you see the service is now running properly. If you remember, initially it was showing some complaints, but now you can see that the WCF service is running properly. Now let me go quickly and let me go and add a console application here just to see that what kind of proxy objects it will generate. So let me go and do a add service reference here very quickly, and let me control V this URL. Now it's reading the WSDL and it's going to go and generate the proxy object. Now you can see that's very interesting, right? you can see that he has used the name value which we have provided in the operation contract, and he is going to go and generate two functions here. One is get data and the other one is get data one. So if I go and generate this proxy class here, and if I now go and try to create the object of the service, so let me just do that. So let me first go and import the namespace here, and if I now go and create the object of the service client here very quickly, and if I do obj dot, you can see that now we have two functions here, but they are having different names. You know, they are not following the same method overloading pattern which has been followed inside the WCF service class. So if you remember, inside the WCF service class we have same method names and different inputs, so it's actually following polymorphism. But over here you can see now it has used the operation contract name here, and with this he has gone ahead and generated two functions, one function with name get data and the other function with the get with the name get data one. And if you see here, the get data actually takes only one input, and if you see get data one, it takes two inputs. So you know, let me answer actually the interview question, okay, or let me answer the answer this question now, the question which has been asked in WCF interviews, that does WCF service support method overloading or not. The answer is yes if you are inside the WCF service here. So here, you know, you can see that he did allow you to go and define the get data with proper method overloading, but the time you generated proxy, right, you know, he is not capable of doing it. And that is logical. Why? Because from the WCF service, right, once you go and generate the proxy, you are going through the SOAP XML file. So from there, you know, the programming breaks off, you know. So that is the object-oriented programming or the object-oriented concepts are only applicable, you know, within the C# code. But once we are talking about SOAP and XML, once you know that layer, right, you know, it's that layer doesn't support object-oriented programming, right? So when you generate the WCF service proxy, you know, he expects, you know, that both the functions name should be same. Why? Because he says that the SOAP XML is not supported to follow object-oriented programming as such, right? It's XML. So XML doesn't do object-oriented programming. So that's why, you know, WCF generated proxies actually do not follow method overloading in WCF service. While internally in WCF service, here definitely you can go and do method overloading, as you can see here, right? So the answer is, you know, when you go and generate the proxy, the WCF service does not follow method overloading. But yes, inside the WCF service, that is on the server, you know, within your code, yes, it does allow you to go and define method overloading. Okay, and in order to ensure that you don't have problems, you can use the operation contract and give unique names here so that, you know, it can generate the proxy accordingly. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand that does WCF service support method overloading. Thank you very much.